This episode of D News is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.
Oh my gosh, I am so stressed. Oh my god. Oh gosh, this is the worst. Oh, I think I'm gonna throw up. Hey guys, Julia here for D News. Stress is really, really awful for your body. You know when you get scared, embarrassed, or anxious, your face flushes and you get all hot and sweaty? Well, this is called a psychogenic fever. Your body temperature actually increases when you're stressed. It's warming up the muscles in case you need to get the hell out of Dodge. Most of the short-term effects of stress are the result of this fight or flight response. The adrenal gland, which sits on top of your kidneys, releases the hormones in response to some stressor. This in turn releases glucose into your bloodstream to power you up, ready to take on a threat. It suppresses your digestion and immune system to save energy for hightailing it away from, like, a bear or something. But nowadays, we aren't threatened so much by bears, but school, work, and family matters stress us out just the same. All of those good things that those hormones do to save us from bears do bad things to us when we're faced with chronic stressors we can't run away from. One of the hormones, cortisol, is called the stress hormone, and it does a lot of different things. It can affect your blood pressure, metabolism, and immune reactions, like inflammation. Basically, chronic stress makes your body continually release cortisol. Normally, this hormone keeps inflammation in check, but after a while, your cells get burnt out and become less receptive to the hormone. Inflammation then kind of runs amok and causes its own host of problems. Inflammation can lead to heart disease and obesity, and is now being implicated in some mental health disorders like depression and anxiety. Inflammation can also damage your DNA. The study, published in the Proceedings of the National Academy of Sciences, found that stress damages your telomeres. Telomeres are often compared to that plastic tip on your shoelaces. They sit on the ends of your chromosomes to keep them from unraveling. As cells divide and DNA replicates, these telomeres shorten throughout your life, eventually leading to cell death. The erosion of telomeres is a pretty good indicator of someone's health. Smokers often have shorter telomeres than non-smokers, for example. In this study, the researchers found that displaced Indian villagers had shorter telomeres than other villagers who didn't go through the stress of relocating, which is similar to other studies on the effects of stress on telomeres. But it's not just having your entire village moved. The American Psychological Association found that Americans are most stressed about work, money, and the economy. Does this sound like you? If you're chronically stressed, there is some hope. Being socially connected helps. One study published in the journal Social and Personality Psychology Compass in 2011 found that people who have supportive, close relationships have lower levels of systemic inflammation compared to those people who have cold, unsupportive, and conflict-ridden relationships. Some studies show that mindfulness-based practices like yoga and meditation can reduce stress. Being mindful means you accept each moment as it is without judgment. Seeing something as neither good or bad, it just is. And it's really hard to do. It definitely takes some training, but it's worth it. One study published in the Annals of Behavioral Medicine reaffirmed previous studies that mindfulness decreases distress and increases quality of life. So do some yoga, take a breath, everything is gonna be a-okay. What are you most stressed about? How do you deal with it? Let us know in the comments below. And while you're at it, hit those like and subscribe buttons and keep coming back here. We've got new episodes every day of the week. This episode of D News is brought to you by the Toyota Corolla. Let's lead the way.